I'm Heather Boushey. I'm the Executive Director at the Washington Center for Equitable Growth. So U.S. Gross Domestic Product, that is GDP, used to be a really excellent measure of what was going on in our economy. In the period after World War II, up until about the late 1970s, when GDP went up in the aggregate, almost everyone all across America, whether you were rich or poor, saw about the same level of income growth. So if GDP grew by about 2%, most Americans also saw their incomes grow at about 2%. And in fact, if you were a low-income person or in a low-income family, you typically saw your income grow higher than the average, whereas if you were a high-income person or high-income family, you saw your incomes grow less than the average. So in that period, we were a nation that was growing together. That all changed somewhere in the late 1970s, early 1980s. Since then, when the GDP goes up, it's mostly those at the very top of the income distribution that see their incomes rise. And in fact, people in the bottom 90% of the income spectrum actually have seen their incomes grow much slower than the economy overall. So that means that this aggregate measure of growth, GDP, no longer tells us what's happening all across America.